I can't believe I launched my collection in Paris. And if you asked me, Steffi, did you know you're gonna be doing this a year ago? I would have absolutely no clue. And if you guys don't know who I am Steffi Fung. I am a digital fashion artist. And today I'm gonna break down my latest collection, which I launched in Paris, the process that went behind it all the way to lead up to the event. So let me bring you behind the scenes and let's start off with the ideation phase. This is the phase where I just get completely sucked into the Pinterest rabbit hole because I'm over here trying to think about the concepts, trying to get inspired, and also think about the topic that I want to get into. And for this collection, we went with the Year of the Dragon. Chinese New Year just passed. It is the Year of the Dragon. It's a freaking awesome creature to work with. And here I am trying to get an idea for my mood board for this concept. And if you guys know my designs, they are always to do with traditional Chinese elements paired with streetwear style. And so in the end, the mood board looked something like this. And I can't remember how long it took me to come up with a concept. Sometimes I can come up with them very quickly, maybe in a day, maybe, you know, a few days. Sometimes it might take me a week or 2 weeks. And they always say, concept is king. Or in this case, concept is queen. Because without the concept, without it having a strong story, meaning, and purpose, your concept or your collection, your design, it's gonna be very empty. And so I always approach all of these projects, whether they're just a singular project, personal project, or a whole collection, I always start with this phase. And so in this mood board, you guys will see a mixture of the graphic design elements, some Chinese, traditional Chinese elements, and also streetwear styles. And I also wanted to add some dragon elements, whether it was the shape of the dragon, whether it was its claws, the colors. I just wanted to make sure that there was some sort of element of the dragon within the design as well. And once I had all of these prepared, I then started sketching. This is the sketching phase. This is highly important because it's good to just get your ideas, everything that you've collected during the ideation phase. I like to sketch it because if it's drawn, then at least I know what I'm working with. I actually sketched around 6 different ideas, but in the end, I only used 4. So there were options and I didn't know how many and wanted to make, but actually the story that I fell into or that completely inspired me in the end had 4 main characters, which is why I guess I start with 4 instead of 6. And so with the story, it all started with the 4 dragons who came from the Eastern Sea. They were playing, they were going from the sea to the air, having fun, but they saw that the humans on Earth weren't happy. So they decided to tell the Jade Emperor up in the heavens, and they told him, they said the humans aren't happy, there's a drought, okay? So there's no water, of course they're not gonna be happy. And so the Jade Emperor said, okay, that's nice. He wasn't really bothered, really. The dragon said, can you please send down some rain, you know, so that we can look after the humans. And the Jade Emperor, he replied saying, yeah, yeah, I'll do it tomorrow. I'll do it tomorrow. So he was very reluctant. He didn't seem to really care. And so the dragons waited for the next day and the rain didn't come. The rain just, it was nowhere to be seen. And so they were confused. They said, oh, the Jade Emperor said he was gonna send rain, but he hasn't. So let's take this into our own hands and let's swallow some water from the Eastern Sea, spray it up into the air, and it will fall down as rain for the humans. And of course the humans were happy, but guess who wasn't happy? You guessed it, the Jade Emperor, right? He didn't like that they disobeyed his orders. Well, they just didn't listen to him, basically. So he imprisoned them under mountains in China, and they in turn turned into the 4 great rivers in China, which are the Long River, the Pearl River, the Black River, and the Pearl River. And so these 4 dragons that I've based on, the 4 dragons, which are the Pearl Dragon, the Long Dragon, the Yellow Dragon, and the Black Dragon. So there's 4 of them. And yes, it's kind of a sad story, but it's also kind of inspiring as well because it really shows the great connection that mythological creatures and nature, you know, they have that connection, and it's super important within Chinese culture. But now that I've told you guys, hopefully you guys should understand it a bit better and it feels like there is a purpose and meaning behind the collection. And so we went through the ideation phase, we went through the sketching phase, and now it's time to build in 3D. It's time for business. And so building in 3D takes the longest. It really does. I think out of the 3 months, majority of those weeks were just building in 3D because 3D is so complicated. There's just so many things that go into it. Whether it's building the garments, lighting it, texturing it, and actually the animation. I did get into animation problems as well, and then rendering as well. And actually creating a collection that is cohesive is quite hard, in my opinion. You want to make sure that all of the pieces speak to each other, that they've got some sort of cohesiveness, they flow into each other, and they're not so different by themselves, but they can stand out by themselves. It's like, it's one of the most difficult things. So I have huge admiration for people who create collections that are more than four, because again, I only had four pieces, and even that was hard. So props to you guys who make collections all the time. And so we start building 3D. I used Clo3D this time to create my collection. And actually, having sketched the idea, it was easier to build the designs because I knew what I was following. Sometimes I skip the sketching phase and I'm just like, ooh, inspiration, bam, like, and I can start making 3D. That's on a good day. When it's not a good day and I just really need to make sure that I got something visual to reference. This took a long time for sure. We got the four that were created, and I also wanted to make masks go along with the outfits. Again, typically my designs don't have an avatar, but I'm sort of leaning into the avatar world now. I'm not sure. I'm like in two minds, because the whole reason why I didn't have avatars in my previous work is because I didn't want people to focus on the avatars. I wanted them to focus on the clothes, the digital garment. But anyways, this time I decided to have the avatars because I really wanted to make these awesome masks and test my ZBrush skills. Let me tell you, I have only tried ZBrush a few times, and then I don't use it, I forget how to use it, and then I try to learn it again for this project. Seeing that I was quite rusty with ZBrush, I'm actually quite proud with how the masks turned out. They might not be the best, but they actually looked quite decent from the front. I'm not even going to show you guys the back, but from the front they look really, really good. And I had a great time just like sculpting, and it's very satisfying. And so the modeling was done with the mask, the garments were made in 3D, the animation was down. Then we moved into texturing, and texturing is where I have the most fun. And honestly, in this collection, I found it easier to start with one design first because that would dictate the rest of the collection as well. And so I started with the yellow dragon, which was this one, this design. And it was quite interesting because I went through a few different color combinations. I was thinking, oh, what textures could I use as well? Because at this point, I knew in my collection, I wanted to have not only digital wearables with Sandbox, but also a physical piece. And so this was gonna be the physical piece. But at that time, when I was designing, I wasn't even thinking of physical. Like, what properties would it be? Like, this material, would it be silk, satin? I didn't really think about that. And in hindsight, if you're going to make physical pieces, you should definitely think about the material and the way that you design. And so I textured the first piece with the mask and also the garments. And once I decided on that, and it did take a few weeks, I think, to even just decide. Was it weeks or days? I can't remember now. Everything's just a blur. In total, I mean, if I were to separate the ideation phase, the sketching phase, 3D would take like this much. Like, ideation phase, sketching phase, 3D, and then the events at the end, and promotion, and like creating marketing materials, like that's at the end. So once I finished one design, I moved on to the rest, and actually it became a lot easier because I knew the presets of, like, if this was gonna be black, then I knew the other parts of the collection's gonna have some black elements in them as well. So texturing the rest became a lot easier after that one. And so these were the pieces. I had to make sure that I textured all the garments, make sure all the masks looks good as well before I put it in a 3D scene in Cinema 4D. And this is where the magic happened, because I knew I wanted to make the scene very naturesque, and I was excited to try this new technique where I would take Chinese illustrations, Chinese paintings, take those elements and put it into a 3D scene, which I've never done before. And so with this, I started sketching on Illustrator, actually on my iPad, some of the Chinese elements that I knew I wanted to bring into my 3D scene. And so we've got loads of rocks, we've got like mountains, we've got the clouds that looks like a swirl, it looks like a brushstroke in the sky. It was really satisfying to put everything together. And of course, because the four dragons were, they came from the Eastern Sea, they also turn into the four great rivers in China, I knew I had to have some water elements in the scene. So once I was done with the yellow dragon scene, so I started off with one, that was then the preset, that was the base that I could use to put the other three dragons in as well. And what was very important was that this needed to look like a collection. They all needed to have their own identity. With each piece, they are a different color. Almost reminds me of like the Powerpuff Girls or like Power Rangers with the way that it came out with all the different colors. Like I always think about where do I get all these references from? And it's probably from things that I've seen or things that I know from my childhood. But aside from texturing and coloring the scene, lighting is also very important, and I spent a long time working on the lighting for these pieces. Wanted to make sure that not only the focus is on the garment, but also the back of the scene is lit beautifully as well. Whenever I light my scenes, I always want to make sure that the brightest spot in the scene is on the garment, like just the garment, and then the background is the background. And another technique I like to use are rim lights. I love to illuminate the back of my garments so that they've got this sort of like outline on the side, like on the shoulder or on the sleeve. There's like a little thin rim light or edge lighting to capture that detail when they are moving. And so once that was done, we move into rendering. Thank God for my 4090, because honestly, I remember on my old GPU, it would take days to render. I'm not kidding. So I was super happy when these animations rendered out within a few hours on my new GPU. And that's what people don't realize with 3D animation. It's not as easy as just rendering out as you wish. It really depends on your tech, and these GPUs are not cheap either. And boom, we have our four animations that are ready. They are done, and that should be the end of the collection, right? Definitely not. It did not end there. So once these four animations were done, I had to make promotional materials for them, for marketing, for social media, to promote so that people can actually know I'm dropping a collection. And actually that took another few weeks because I had to render out extra shots. I had to re-render things out, maybe without the background, because this collection was going to be dropped on Psyche. I am currently in the Psyche Collective, which is a digital fashion community and collective and platform pushing and supporting emerging digital fashion artists like myself. And so this was a big deal for me, not only for them, but for me as well, because I have not dropped an NFT collection for a while, maybe for over a year. And not only that, I was dropping an NFT Paris where I was also doing a panel talk, and it was just like the week before Paris Fashion Week, so no pressure. And I'm just gonna pause this video to just tell you guys that if you are enjoying this video so far about my process, about my thoughts as a digital fashion artist, come and join my Patreon. We have a lovely community on there with people just like you who are interested in digital fashion, interested in the future of fashion, and want to know more about technical skills, industry insights, and career advice as well. So it's just like this YouTube video, but times 10. So if you're interested in that, make sure to check it out and I will see you there. Okay, back to the video. We were talking about promotional materials so that we can start advertising it and making people aware that I am dropping a collection. And not just any collection, but an NFT collection. And the reason why I wanted to drop it during NFT Paris is because I truly believe in NFT technology. And I've been talking about it for many years now. But it was my first time dropping a collection at an event. That was truly scary. So thank you, Psyche, for organizing all of that. And I'll tell you what, for the whole 5 days I was there, I was working nonstop, I was networking. I mean, that's what a lot of people go to NFT Paris for, is to see the latest projects in Web3, to talk to the people in the space, to get to know people in the space. But to be honest, majority of that week, for the days I was there, I was working a lot. And it was quite a lot of pressure because, again, I was just mentally tired from preparing, again, 3 month project. By the end of those 3 months, I was just like, I'm done with the project. I'm so proud of it, but I just want it to be out. So during that week, I was working, I was stressed, I was networking, trying to like get things done, film content for you guys as well for like TikTok and Instagram. So that was just a lot going on. And then it finally came to the day when I had to present not only and reveal my Fidgetal piece, which was made by Fidgetal Twin. Shout out to them. Thank you so much for working with me on this. Not only was I revealing this piece for the first time ever, but I also had to prepare myself for a panel talk in front of like 100 people. There was loads of people there right in front of me. So I was super nervous on that day. But actually once I got to the event, it wasn't as bad as I thought. But as a pioneer in this space, I do spend a lot of time going to panel talks, talking about digital fashion, and sharing awareness about it and what I do as a digital fashion artist. So to be honest, I don't know why I was very nervous that day, but I guess it was just the added pressure of launching something on that same day. I had an event in the evening where I invited a lot of people from the Web3 world, from digital fashion world, from Web3 gaming. There was just a lot of people in that space, and I just, again, my first time doing something like that, and so I was nervous. I think that's normal, right? And actually, I got to meet a lot of new people in the space, and all of these people are interested in digital fashion, or they wanted to learn more about digital fashion, which I think is incredible because this space is still so new. So thank you to anyone who came to my event and came to support, came to my panel talk. Honestly, that day was just exhilarating. Like, I just felt like it finally came out, you know. I was relieved, I was excited, I was proud. There was just so many emotions that came along with it. So that day was a launch, which meant people could start buying my works, they could start buying their NFT tokens. And honestly, in the Web3 space, in the crypto space, in the NFT space, it hasn't been easy for the past year because the whole market was slow and it went down. And I'm happy to talk more about that on this channel if you guys are interested in learning more about why digital fashion is so closely tied to NFTs and the Web3 space. I didn't know if anybody wanted to buy my pieces. I always have imposter syndrome every time I release an NFT artwork or digital fashion piece because I'm like, who is gonna buy this? Who is gonna collect this? But people did, and I'm so grateful every single time. So thank you so much for the support to anyone who has collected a piece of mine from this collection. And again, I think it's important to not put high expectations on selling out every collection. It would be amazing if you could, but the realities of it is that maybe you won't sell out. Maybe you will sell a few, but either way, you would have learned something and you would know how to price it or how to go about selling a collection in the future. And so that is how I launched a digital fashion collection in Paris. And I will say again, thank you for the support. Thank you to anyone who has collected a piece. I truly appreciate you guys. And I think it's super interesting to see how digital fashion continues to merge the traditional fashion industry to the digital aspects of Web3 and gaming. So thank you so much for watching till the end. If you're still here at the end of the video, give yourself a virtual high five. Again, if you guys are interested in learning more about digital fashion in depth, whether it's about Web3, digital fashion techniques, actually what programs you need to work with, or if you want to know about the industry or career insights, then come to my Patreon. There's a lot more content that we do on there, and it helps to support this YouTube channel as well. Thank you for watching the video, and let's keep in touch on Twitch, Discord, and Patreon, and I'll see you in the next video.